peace has been purchased for us. Isaiah chapter 53 and verse 5. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. The Bible tells us that when Jesus Christ died on the cross, he took upon himself our sins, our transgressions, and our iniquities. The very things that distanced us from God, the very things that broke down our relationship with God, he took it on himself, and he paid the punishment for our sins. But very interestingly, the Bible also says that the punishment for our peace was upon him. That means the punishment he took upon himself was a punishment that paid or purchased our peace. Now, in the Old Testament, the word for peace is shalom. And the word shalom is an all-inclusive word. It's an all-encompassing word. It's a word that not only talks about the tranquility of the state of tranquility, a peace of mind, but it talks about well-being in every area of our lives, that we can have peace in every facet of life, whether it's relationships, finances, situations, or overcoming difficulties. We can have total well-being, and that's what shalom is. Shalom means total wellness of spirit, soul, body, and every aspect of life. That everything is in a state of wholeness, in a state of well-being. That is shalom. And that is the Bible kind of peace. And here the Bible is saying in Isaiah 53 and verse 5, that the punishment, the price to purchase our shalom was paid on the cross. So I want us to understand that the peace of God, the peace that God is making available to us, comes to us through the cross of Jesus. It is made available to us because somebody purchased it for us. The Lord Jesus Christ purchased it for us. That means he made it possible for the peace of God to be given to our lives by paying the price for everything that would obstruct or hinder that peace from being given to us. The sin and the transgressions are our failures. He paid for it. He took it out of the way so that now the peace of God can come into our lives. You and I can receive shalom, total well-being, through the cross of Jesus by believing in what Jesus Christ did for us on the cross, and by saying and declaring our faith in the fact that Jesus paid for it. Jesus died so that you and I can have shalom and total well-being in our lives. So if there is any area of our lives that is disturbed, that is not in shalom, we can look to the cross and say, Jesus, you paid for it so that I could have shalom. And I receive shalom. I receive wholeness, well-being, peace in these areas of my life, because the punishment for our shalom was upon him. So today, I want to encourage you to look to the cross of Jesus, to look to Jesus Christ, the one who paid for your shalom, for my shalom. And by faith, we receive that into our lives. As I pray, I want you to believe that the shalom of God will touch your life in every facet, in every area of your life, because Jesus Christ died so that you could have it. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you that the punishment for our shalom, our peace, was upon you, that you took it upon yourself, Jesus. And so right now, in the name of Jesus, by the power of the Holy Spirit, and on the basis of the finished work of Christ on the cross, I command shalom into the lives of every person watching, listening. Let the peace of God invade their lives, and let everything that robs them of shalom be thrown out of their lives. Receive shalom. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.